Bhashyakara, coming to the third Brahmana discusses the result of the most exalted karma, which is Ashwamedha karma, and the connected upasana. And what's the reason why this next Brahmana discusses that is to show the avadhi or the extent, you know, the highest limit of what can be achieved as a result of karma and the upasana. Now, when you say that both punya and papa karma constitute the samsara, then you should discuss both punya karma and papa karma in order that we understand what's the result of that and to create vairagya. How come this Brahmana only discusses the result of punya karma? Because Bhashyakara says the result of the papa karma is something that is very well known. So, svabhava bahu dukkha bahuleshu sthavara jangameshu nargatirek pretadishu cha dukkha manubhodi punah punah jayamanah. That because of the predominance of papa karma, one born again and again, so gets birth into all those yonis where there is predominance of dukkha. So this is sarvaloka prasiddham, that is something that is well known to everyone. Well, then it's also well known that by punya karma also one attains good yoni. That also is known. Yattu shastriya hai punya vai punya in karmana bhavati tatrai vadara hai kriyate hai shrutya. Shruti here does the adara, meaning shows focuses attention or shows the respect for the punya karma. Punya meva cha karma sarupurtha, because by punya, so one may not know the effect of the punya karma, meaning one may not know what is the extent of the achievement of the punya karma, and therefore vairagya from the result of punya karma is rather difficult to attain. Vairagya from the result of papa karma is something easy. Nobody wants dukkha. Everybody wants sukha, and therefore to have vairagya from the result of punya karma is something difficult. Therefore, Shruti wants to show that even the result of highest punya karma also is within the realm of samsara. Punyameva cha karma sarapurthas purushad sadhanam iti sarve shruti smriti vadaha. The Shrutis and Smritis say that by punya karma one can attain all the desired ends. Mokshasyavi purushadattvat tasadhira prapta. And moksha also the purushad, so someone may think that also can be attained as a result of punya karma. And so that idea has to be removed. Yavad yavad punyotkarsha tavat tavat phalotkarsha praptihi. Again also it's well known that to the extent there is an excellence of punya karma, to that extent there is an excellence of the result. Tasmad uttamena punyotkarsena moksha bhavishyati ashanka syat. So there can be a doubt, or there can be a thought, you know, a conclusion on the part of one, that by the highest punya karma that one can attain moksha, which is the highest achievement. In Ashwamedha is the highest punya karma. So one may think that by Ashwamedha one may attain moksha iti ashanka syat. Sa nivartayitavya, and that ashanka, or that kind of a conclusion that one may have, has to be removed. Jnana sahitasya cha prakrishta karma etavati gatihi. The Shruti must say that this is the gati, this is the extent of what one can achieve as a result of karma along with upasana. Vyakrita naam rupaspadatvat karmanah tatphalasya cha padha. The reason why punya karma or any kind of karma, including punya karma of course, so if anything can attain moksha, it is punya karma only, but even punya karma also cannot attain moksha because vyakrita naam rupaspadatvat, because karma has its ashraya in the name and form which is always vyakrita. Of course there are name and form that avyakrita, avyakrita means undifferentiated, unmanifest, but they are of no practical use as far as performance of karma is concerned, or even as far as experiencing results are concerned. You can't experience results, you can't perform karma, nor experience result with a name and form which is not yet manifest. And so, vyakrita naam rupaspadatvat karmanah tatphalasya cha, that karma and its phala can be there, meaning karma can be performed, and phala can be experienced only when vyakrita naam rupa is there. Nutu akarye nitye avyakrita dharmini anam rupatmake kriyakaraka phala svabhava varjite karmanah vyapara asti. And so karma, which can be performed with vyakrita naam rupa, and the result of which can be experienced with Akrutanam Rupa, cannot have its reach in with reference to that which is beyond this name and form. So nitya akarya karma can bring about something that is born. Karma can produce something. This is akaryam, which is not a product. Nitya, whatever karma will produce is perishable also. This is imperishable. Avyakra dharmini, naam rupa dharmini. So moksha or atma is avyakrata naam rupa dharmi. It is that which is devoid of any names and forms, and therefore also karma, which only functions in the realm of names and forms, cannot have its reach there. Anam rupatmake, which is, so karma again will produce a result which can be experienced through sense perception, whereas atma is that which is beyond the realm of sense perception. Therefore also anam rupatmake kriyakaraka phalasvabhavavarjite. Atma is neither kriya nor karaka nor phala. So karma again is in the realm of kriya, karaka and phala. Atma is none of these. Tasmin karma na vyapara nasti. There is no vyapara of karma in atma such as that. And wherever that vyapara is, yatra cha vyapara hai, saha samsara hai. And wherever the karma has its vyapara, that is samsara. So that has to be shown, that wherever is the reach of karma, that is samsara. That has to be shown. Samsara eva iti asya arthasya pradarshanaya brahmanam arabhyate. So wherever, whatever is the reach of karma, that is samsara. That is what has to be established, and for that purpose this brahmana is commenced here. Now on the page 736 there is this Krodapatra. This is Shastriyam Karma Sarvapi Samsara Phalameva Idi Vaktum Brahmanam Idi. So this Brahmana is devoted to demonstrating this or revealing this, the Shastriyam Karma Sarvapi Samsara Phalameva. Shastriyam Karma and Punya Karma also is within the realm, the phala is within the realm of samsara. Idi Vaktum Brahmanam. So this Brahmana is devoted to revealing this truth, that Shastriya Karma is within the realm of samsara. Nanu Vaidya Karma Phalam Samsarakyam Pragevoktam. And the question is, Vaidya Karma Phalam, the karma phala, Vaidya Karma Phala, the karma phala of the Vaidya, the phala of the Vaidya Karma, Samsarakyam, this has been stated earlier, that as a result of Vaidya Karma, one attains samsara. That is, one remains within the realm of samsara, not attains samsara, but remains in the realm of samsara. Iti Pragevoktam, this has been stated earlier. Tatkim anena brahmanena iti. Then what new is said by this brahmana? You seem to be repeating this. Both in an Upanishad like this, lot of things are going to be repeated, you know. And so I don't think that is much of a dosha, because it's a huge thing. And there were lots of topics are repeated. But still they insist that nothing should be repeated. Anyway, I don't think that has to be insisted. But anyway, tatkim anena brahmanena. So what is it that this, what is new that this brahmana is establishing? Iti ashankya. Asya apunaruktam vishayam vaktum. Well, even though there may be repetition, every brahmana has to contribute something new. Either it will present some new standpoint, it will reveal some new dimension, or it will tell you something that has not been stated. So either it says something that has not been said, which is fine, or if it says what has been said, it may say in a different way, bring out a different aspect, show a different dimension. So that way every brahmana has its own uniqueness, no doubt about that. So whereas repetition is there, and still uniqueness also is there, which also we should know. And so tatkim anena brahmanena. So what is unique about this brahmana? Then this topic has been discussed earlier also. Iti ashankya asya apunaruktam vishayam vaktum, that this brahmana is not totally repeating what has been said earlier, but it is a vishaya or subject matter which is, it's unique also. कर्मफलभेदम आहु वार्तिकाचार्याः दैट वार्तिकाचार्य सेज कर्मफलभेदम द कर्मफल वाज डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर दैट इट इज इन द रियलम ऑफ संसारा दिस वन ऑल्सो डिस्कसेस कर्मफल बट देयर इज अ डिफरेंस देयर कर्मफलभेदम कर्म इज वॉट एवर इट इज बट द कर्मफल दैट कर्मफल ऑल्सो इज अ डिफरेंट टाइप एंड टू शो दैट भेद इज दिस ब्राह्मण दिस इज व्हाट वार्तिकाचार्य सेज साधारण्य विशेषाभ्याम कर्मणश्च व्यवस्थितिः विशेषावस्था प्रागुक्ता सामान्यं तदनुच्यते नाउ इन दी सिक्स्थ लाइन ऑफ द सेम ऑन द सेम पेज वी सी दी एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ दीज वर्सेस कर्मणः समष्टिरूपेण व्यष्टिरूपेण च द्विधा फलस्थितिः इत्यर्थः कर्मणः समष्टिरूपेण व्यष्टिरूपेण सो द्विधा फलस्थितिः कर्म गिव्स राइज टू टू फोल्ड फल एट द लेवल ऑफ समष्टि एट द लेवल ऑफ व्यष्टि सो कर्म इज व्हाट इट इज कर्म इज कर्म बट द फल कैन बी एट द लेवल ऑफ व्यष्टि इंडिविजुअल समष्टि द टोटल सो द्विधा फलस्थितिः टू फोल्ड इज द फलस्थिति मीनिंग द नेचर ऑफ फल ऑफ द कर्म व्यष्टिरूपेण तत्फलस्थितिः उद्गीत ब्राह्मणे उक्ता इन उद्गीत ब्राह्मण ऑफ विच दिस इज ए मोर इलाबोरेशन एंड प्रोवाइडिंग द रीजनिंग बिहाइंड दैट सपोजली यू नो सो दैट वाज द कनेक्शन दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रकरण हैज एंड सो दैट द सब्जेक्ट मैटर डिस्कस इन उद्गीत ब्राह्मण इज इलाबोरेटेड हियर बाय प्रोवाइडिंग द रीजनिंग सो व्यष्टि रूपेण तत्फलस्थितिः उद्गीत ब्राह्मणे उक्ता इन द उद्गीत ब्राह्मण विच इज 113 And so there, I mean not once, but then first chapter in the third Brahmana rather. So there, this, what is the Vyashti, meaning what is the result of the karma at the Vyashti level? What happens to the individual level, and what happens to the individual level, that was being said there. Saha Agni Abhavad Ityadina Ukta. So how this person became Agni? Meaning by meditating upon the totality. As you said, the organ of speech is nothing but a fraction of the fire. So by looking upon the organ of speech as total fire, then one becomes fire. So identifying with that this speech is nothing but the fire and that I am, so that is what makes, creates an identification with fire. And so, saha agni abhavat, he became agni, ityadena ukta. This is the vyashti rupena phalasthiti. Vyashti here is at the limbs. So agni, etc. are all the limbs of Hiranyagarbha. And samashti will be becoming Hiranyagarbha. So becoming the limbs of Hiranyagarbha, such as fire or wind or all these gods, that would be Vyashti Vyavasthiti. And becoming Hiranyagarbha would be this Samashti Vyavasthiti. This is how we would understand. Ityadana Uktayadi Parisheshasam Smarayadi. So first of all, Vartikacharya says that yes, the result of the karma at the level of Vyashti or individual limbs has been stated. So, sadharanya visheshabhyam karmanascha vyavasthitihi. So, karma phala is a vyavasthiti that it gives rise to result at the level of individual or at the level of total. Visheshavastha pragukta. Vishesha means the individual, samanya means total. Vishesha means the vyashti, samanya means samashti. Visheshavastha pragukta. Saha agnihi abhavat, that he became fire god, so that is a visheshavastha, he becoming something particular, so one aspect of the totality, that's what he becomes. Samanyam tu adhuna uchade, when you become totality, then you are not confined to just one aspect, you are all the aspects, that is the Hiranyagarbha, and so samanyam tu adhuna uchade, this brahmana tells us the samanyam meaning this samashti. So that's what the Tika says. Atha asya apunaruktam vishayamaha samanyam tu, that this brahmana says the result of karma at the samanya or samashti level. Karma phalam samashti rupam sautram nirupayitum ityetada. So this brahmana etat is, this brahmana is for delineating the result of karma at the samasti level, at the level of sutra, Hiranyagarbha. This is the idea. Then the Tika continues, Nanu, Vaidika karma phalam sautram samsarupam ihuchyate. So this Brahmana says, no doubt, Vaidika karma phalam sautram. Sautram means pertaining to sutra, meaning Hiranyagarbha. So even the attainment of the state of Hiranyagarbha also is within the realm of samsara. That is what is being said here. Tachya samasti vyasti atmakamidhi. But that also is the level of samasti and vyasti. You know, ukta, vyavastha, ukta. That vyavastha that you are saying that the karma phala is at the level of samasti and vyasti, na ukta. That is not proper. Na yukta. Tachya vyasti amsham upadishya samasti amsham upadishtum idamidhi shrishtam. Nor can you very clearly say that what has been earlier taught was the result of the vyasti level, and this only teaches in the samasti level. Even that vyavastha, or that division also cannot be clearly made. Tasyabhi mrityuvasya atma bhavati iti uktatva. So, tasyabhi mrityuvasya atma bhavati, while discussing the death, it was said mrityuvasya atma bhavati, mrityu becomes the atma. Iti uktatva dataha. So, the argument here is that the samasti also has been stated. It's not that this only, the vyasti alone was stated earlier and this alone states the samasti. So, that division, clear division also doesn't appear to be there. Therefore, Vartikara is samsara idi. Samsare kiyati vyaptihi abhivyaktasya karmanaha samanyatma visheshabhyam ityetat bhujyanochyute. Samsare kiyati vyaptihi abhivyaktasya karmanaha. Abhivyaktasya karmanaha, karma, that is just abhivyakta meaning, when it becomes a karma phala, then samsare kiyati vyaptihi, what is the extent of the karma phala in the samsara? Samanyatma visheshabhyam, at the level of samanya and vishesha, ityetat bhujyana uchyate. This is what bhujyu in this Brahma says. So, Tika explains that dvayoho avasthayoho uktatvebi. Yes, you are right, that the two avasthas have been said earlier, that the samasti also has been mentioned earlier. Even then, arabdha karmanaha, so abhivyaktasya karmanaha. Abhivyaktasya karmanaha means prarabdha karma. So, sanchitam karma is not yet abhivyaktam, and prarabdha karma is that is abhivyaktam, so abhivyaktasya karmanaha. So, what Bhujju is asking specifically is, what is the extent of the reach of the prarabdha karma? So, dvayoho avasthayoho uktatvevi arabdha karmanah samasti vyasti rupena kyadi phalavyaptihiti. That the prarabdha karma samasti vyasti rupena, at the level of samasti and vyasti, what is the extent of the prarabdha karma? Iti ashankaya, if this ashanka is there, you know, anyway, so tat parimanam samsare antarbhutaya tan matramavetit anena bhujju brahmanena uchyate. So bhujjuna means bhujju brahmanena. So by this third brahmana called bhujju brahmana, so because Vartikara said etat bhujjuna uchyate, not by the person bhujju but by the brahmana bhujju brahmana. Iti ashankayam, well, this, so people who are totally devoted to karma and truly identified with karma can have all these questions. We are oriented to understanding that jnana is a means of moksha and karma is not. So, many questions which are the fine points of karma may not arise with us, because karma has been basically dismissed as a direct means of moksha. It has been accepted as a means of antahakan shuddhi, and so no problem. But that is a direct means of moksha, and we don't even look at it. That being the case, the fine aspects of the result of karma may not occur to us. But those who insist upon looking upon karma as a direct means of moksha, they will say, all right, sanchita karma is one thing, agami karma is another thing, prarabdha karma is yet another thing. And that part of the karma which has become manifest is prarabdha karma. So, what is the extent to which it can take a person? Tat parimanam samsare antara bhutataya tan matrameva. Even parimana is measurement, even that vyapti also is within the realm of samsara alone. Iti edat anena bhujju brahmanena uchyate. And so, Bhaji Brahmana says specifically about the extent of the prarabdha karma. And so, tad artha vishesha siddhi ityartha. And therefore, that artha vishesha siddhi, this Brahmana does contribute something unique or something different. Nanu purvamapi samsaratmakameva karma phalam uktam. Not karma phala yuktam, but karma phalam uktam. Tasya sutrasya mrityoho ashanayaditva sutehedi ashankya. Again, the question is, this has also been stated. Nanu purvamapi samsaratmakameva karma phalam uktam. Earlier also was said that karma phala, whether vyasti or samasti, is in the realm of samsara, is in stated. Tasya sutrasya mrityoho ashanayaditva sutehedi. That sutratma also was called mrityu, because that is also in the realm of ashanaya and pipasa. So that also is not, this all discussions came right here in the beginning of this, the earlier Brahmana itself, that even the sutra, meaning Hiranyagarbha also, is not beyond the scope of the graha and atigraha. Because Hiranyagarbha also is said to have a limb. It also has, it has a speech. They said that it is called a samasti speech, and of which the earth is the gross aspect of the speech, and the fire is the subtle aspect of the speech, and then it has other limbs also. And so, all of this, it is also the faculty of hearing, of which akasha becomes, it is also the mind, of which akasha becomes a body, and the chandrama becomes the subtle aspect of it. And so, sutratma also has his limbs, and therefore, there he also within the scope of graha and atigraha, and within the scope of samsara. And so, mrityoho ashanayadimatva shrutehe. That sutratma also has ashanaya pipasa at a very subtle level. So it has been clarified that even the sutratma also is within the realm of samsara, it is stated. So, then what is again new that this Brahmana tells us? Vivakshitam artham artha vishesham aha. Vivakshitam artha vishesham. So what is this artha vishesha? What is the vishesha or something different artha that this Brahmana intends to say, that Vashyakara brings out here? I mean, Vartikara pratyagyati. Pratyagyathātmi mohasya kāryayatteha bhanyate etasyām samyuktāyām nānuktam avshishyate. Pratyagyathātmi mohasya. Pratyagyathātmi moha. Pratyag means a pratyagatma. Yathātmyam as a pratyagatma is. Moha means a delusion about the true nature of pratyagatma. Everyone knows pratyagatma, all right, but yathātmyam, one does not know the atma as it is in its true nature. So moha delusion is pertaining to the true nature of the atma. So pratyag yathātmyam mohasya kārya yatta iha bhanyate. So this is explained further. Say the tika sādhyam sarvam. So avidyottamevaiti. That is called pratyek yathatma moha. Pratyek yathatma is explained in tika as sva. Pratyek means sva. Moha means avidya. So sva avidya uttameva sadhyam sarvam. Anything that is accomplished in this world or in this creation is something that is born of the ignorance of the self. So the idea of sadhyam, the idea of something to be attained itself is created because of ignorance. Nāna vāptam vāptabhim, Lord Krishna says, there is nothing for me that is not attained. So as long as one feels that there is something that still remains to be attained, that shows ignorance. Because if ātmā is pūrṇa, then it is all-inclusive, and therefore there can be nothing that is not attained. And therefore the idea of attaining something, sādhya, that something is to be attained, itself is a product of ignorance about one's own self. Because when one knows oneself in its true nature, one knows that nothing remains to be attained. Sādhyam sarvam sva avidyottamevaiti asmin brahmane kathyate. So this brahmana says that sādhyam, meaning even Hiranyagarbha also, is nothing but the result of the ignorance of one's own self. Ataha arthabhedat agatārthata ityārthaha. So that kind of arthabheda is that sādhyam sarvam, so everything that is attained is in the realm of ignorance. So pratyag yathātmi mohasya कार्य इयत्ता इह कार्य इयत्ता इह मन्यते कार्य इयत्ता इयत्ता मीन्स दिस मच यू नो द एक्सटेंट कार्य इयत्ता मीन्स दैट विच साध्य इयत्ता दैट्स हाउ वी अंडरस्टैंड यू नो साध्य इयत्ता मीन्स द एक्सटेंट ऑफ साध्य इह मीन्स इन दिस ब्राह्मण दैट्स सो दैट्स व्हाट द टीका सेज इह मीन्स अस्मिन् ब्राह्मणे कथ्यते सो इह इह भण्यते मीनिंग अस्मिन् ब्राह्मणे कथ्यते इन दिस ब्राह्मण इट इज सेड वॉट कार्ययता मीनिंग वॉट साध्यम सर्वम इयत्ता मीन्स एक्सटेंट एंड कार्य मीन्स दैट विच इज टू बी अटेन्ड सो एक्सटेंड ऑफ वॉट एवर दैट कैन बी अटेन्ड मीनिंग साध्यम इज ऑल विद इन द रियलम ऑफ द इज अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द इग्नोरेंस ऑफ वन ओन सेल्फ दिस इज वॉट दिस ब्राह्मण सेज अतः अर्थभेदात अगतार्थता इत्यर्थः एंड देयरफॉर सिंस सम भेद ऑफ द अर्थ इज देयर दिस दस डील विथ ए सब्जेक्ट मैटर विच इज स्लाइट डिफरेंट देयर इज नॉट द पुनरुक्ति और टोटल रेपिटेशन हियर देन द टीका सेज मोह कार्य यत्नोक्ति फलमाह व्हाट्स द रीजन व्हाई यू मस्ट हैव यत्नोक्ति सो यत्नोक्ति फलम मोह कार्य So, that which is the result of moha, where the prayatna, so, what is the reason why you are saying it? Moha kaye yatnokti phalamaha. What's the reason why you are describing this? So, phalam says, Avartikacharya, etasyam samyuktayam na anuktam avasishyate. When this is well properly said, then nothing remains to be said also. So, when you say that anything that is sadhyam is within the realm of ignorance, And that includes even the state of Hiranyagarbha. So when this is established, then nothing remains to be stated as far as the Vairagya is concerned. Anuktam meaning dvait antahpati iti shesha. Nothing remains to be stated within the realm of duality. So when you say that what highest of the sadhya also is in the realm of ignorance, then whatever needs to be stated about duality has been stated. That everything in the realm of duality is in the realm of ignorance. That gets to be stated. And therefore, Edasyam Samyuktayam. When this becomes very clear, then na anuktam avashishyade, nothing remains to be unsaid as far as the delineation of duality is concerned. So then one has dealt with duality. What to the extent that it needs to be dealt with? Because that is required, we must know the total dimension of duality. Otherwise, one's fascination will not go. So once Swami we met, you know, his last following, many years ago in Mount Abu when we met him, then he said, why are you studying Upanishads and things, you know? Then he dismissed Upanishads and everything. He was some tantric person or doing some kind of upasana. So we said, what should I go? He says, well, I want to go into that star, you know, particular star, that's where I want to go. So the thing is that these fascinations may remain. All kinds of fascinations of people, that is a high fascination, but even little fascinations remain for people to go to Germany and stuff like that, or Switzerland, whatever, and then go to Alps and do something. So unless you really have a survey of what this world has to offer, at every level of sense organ, you know, at every level of sense organ, whatever this world has to offer, one has to have a knowledge, means at least one has to have an understanding. I don't say an experience, but one has to have an understanding of what the realm of duality has to offer at every level. I was reading the stories of Veda Vyasa and everybody had to go through this stuff. All kinds of temptations come and they fall for it also. And again they have to rise and then, you know, so when you fall for it, then rising becomes pretty tough, then they have to rise again, you know. So all kinds of temptations come, including temptation in case of Vedavyasa, temptation of the son. There was tremendous attachment there and he was just lost when his son left him. And so Sri Narada had to come and really console him and all kinds of things were required. And whatever else also happened, so in the life of all these sages also, things have happened. The idea is that it seems that whenever anybody starts tapascharya, then if the devatas become active, you know, And all kinds of obstacles are sent in there on the path. And very rarely people, in spite of sages being so great as they were, hardly there is anybody in India also whom we revere so much. Hardly any sage has really been able to save himself or me to keep himself free from those tremendous temptations. So these are very practical people. Our scriptures are very practical. On one hand, telling us this is what it is. So what is the extent of the self-control and the vairagya that is required on one hand? At the same time, telling what people have achieved and therefore what a human being can achieve. So both of these have been stated. And so the extent of duality has to be very clearly understood. What can be attained by you? You should better know. Suppose I did this, then I could have gotten that. Yes. Suppose I did this, then I would have attained that. Yes. Suppose you attained that and that and this. And then you should have clarity about it. Even then it's okay. Even then I do not want it, you know. So tavaivaha tavandrutya gite. If one can very boldly say that, and firmly, not boldly, firmly and clearly say that. So that is what Yamaraja wanted from Nachiketa. Everything was offered to Nachiketa, you know. Of course we say it's a small boy. We don't understand the meaning of what was offered to him, whatever it is. But still, everything was offered to him. And he said. So what we are saying is that we should know what vairagya means. And what is the extent of vairagya? Because any kind of an attachment, if it's anything, even potential attachment also can become a source of distraction of the mind. Because when you want nistha, when you want an abidance, then the mind must be free from every distraction. And therefore, that is what is vairagya is. Vairagya means a lack of attachment or mahatva buddhi for anything. If mahatva buddhi remains in something, that becomes an obstacle. And so, not that you have to throw away the mahatva buddhi, but you have to discover mahatva of this self is greater than other things. Everything has its mahatva, but when we understand that this has the greatest mahatva, then of course the mahatva buddhi from that will go, or the fascination for that will go. In short, in our life, every kind of fascination has to go. Not by way of aversion or by way of rejection, but by way of discovering the value of the self. And then alone the fascination for non-self goes. But it is tremendously fascinating. That's why this Brahmana discusses, even at this extent also. Of course, Hiranyagarbha is the highest thing that you can think of. But mohakarye yatna yatnokti haram. You are making yatna of saying it this again and again, because when this is well said, when this is well understood, etasya samyuktayam, when it is well said and hopefully well understood, na anuktam avashishyate, nothing remains to be said, nor nothing remains to be understood, when we understand it properly. In the realm of duality, of course, the non-duality remains to be said, but you said whatever needs to be said about the duality.
Vaidika karmaphalasya avidyotha bandhamadhyapatitvameva iti vaktamitat brahmaniti yuktam.
Okay. So, Vaidika karmaphalasya avidyotha bandhamadhyapatitvam. Even Vaidika karmaphala also is within the realm of bondage, which is a product of ignorance. Iti vaktum etat brahmanam, to say that is the purpose of this brahmana. Katham sarvapi karmaphalam samsaratvena atra vivakshitam. Vaidika karmaphalam, all right. Katham sarvapi karmaphalam. So, samsaratvena atra vivakshitam. Why do you say that all the karma? Maybe apart from Vaidika karma, there may be some other karmas, you know. So, how do you say that just because Vaidika karma is within the realm of samsara, that all the karma phala is within the realm of samsara? How can you say that? Vruna. And so says the verse, Vruna hatya swamedhabhyam na param pava punyayoho. Ityevam dharma karanam api vakyani koti shahidi. So Vaidhi karma includes every kind of karma. In short, when you discuss the extent of Vaidhi karma, then every karma is included. Why? Because what is the greatest papa? Bhruna hatya. See, this is supposed to mean the abortion is looked upon as a tremendous papa, you know, by the way. Bhruna hatya means the killing the embryo. And Brahma hatya, of course, killing a Brahmana, but Bhruna hatya also is looked upon as a tremendous sin. Anyway, that's a different topic here, it's not relevant. Ashwamedha abhyam. And Ashwamedha is supposed to be the highest virtue, or highest, virtuous action, punya karma. Na param pava punyayoho. So So, papa and punya, there is nothing which is more sin than bhrunahatya, and there is no greater punya than ashwamedha. When both these are discussed, then what remains to be discussed? Itivam dharmakaranapi vakyani kotishaya dharmakarana means dharma shastris. They also, many the smrutis. So many of these vakyas are there where this has been stated very, very clearly. Kotishaya, crores of vakyas are there. So when these are dealt with, everything is as well dealt with. Says the Tika, bhavatam papanam punyanam samadhi brahmavadha ashwamedhascha mahanto. All right, let it be. That okay, punyanam papanam samadhi, within punya and papa, brahmavadha ashwamedhascha mahanto bhavatam. All right, let ashwamedha be the greatest punya, and brahmahatya or bhrunahatya may be the greatest papa. Okay, we accept that. Tathavi katham sarvam karma phalam. Still, he is asking, you know. See, how do you say that all the karma phala is, there can be other karmas than this, samsaraha, tatraha. Iti evam dharmakaranapi vakyani kodishaha. Mahantav. They may be great, but they can be greater papa than brahmahatya and greater punya than ashwamedha. Why not? He says, no, there is no greater papa than that and no greater punya than that. This is what the dharma shastras very clearly say. And therefore, having discussed them, everything is as well discussed. Iti evam dharmakaranapi vakyani kotisha. Iti shabdena ukta brahmavadhadi paramarshaha. Iti. So, this bhrunahatya and ashwamedha, this is the paramarshaha. Evam shabdena tat sadrusha punya punya prakaropihi. So, iti evam. So, what is the punya of ashwamedha? What's the papa of the Brunahatya, all of this dharma shastra is very clearly delineated. So explaining that, tathacha brahma vadhena tat sadusaisya papaihi ashwamedhena tat tulya punyaisya. Suppose there is a papa, see, you say that brunahatya, suppose the shastra talks about the result of brunahatya, but suppose this fellow did brahmahatya, then what? So that's a different kind of papa karma, you know. So all right. But when you discuss the result of bhrunahatya, then every other kind of papa, you know, there is no papa greater than that. And therefore, if you can deal with that, you have dealt with other things, you know. So, brahmavadhena tat sadrushaischa papaihi. Brahmavadha or any papa, which is, suppose in future people can discover all kinds of papa, you know, which they did not think of. So, the smrutikara also may not have thought of papa, which people are capable of performing. In the time to come. But then there can be no papa that is greater than this, you know. So, tat brahmavadhena tat sadushaischa papaihi. So, brahmavadha, brahma means a brahmin or a person who is really highly evolved. To assassinate or kill somebody highly evolved is the greatest sin, you know. Because he represents really the highest, one of the highest creations of nature or highest evolutions of nature. And killing more evolved thing is a greater sin than killing less evolved things. Killing is sin anyway, but still, if you want to determine which is a greater sin, then that which involves killing of a more evolved soul is a greater sin than killing the less evolved soul. That is the argument of vegetarianism versus eating meat. That eating vegetarian food also involves killing, no doubt about that. But killing of vegetables and plants, which are at a much lower level of evolution as compared to animals, who are at a higher level of evolution, of that, cow is supposed to be at a much higher level of evolution. Cow is the highest evolved animal according to the Vedas anyway. And therefore, this gohatya is the greatest sin. Killing other animals also is sin. But still less evolved animals, like all the, the tigers and all these the cruel animals, so they are less evolved as compared to gentle animals. Among gentle animals also, cow would be considered the most evolved, and therefore the hatya would be a great sin. Human being is even more evolved than that. In human being also there are categories and categories. In that a brahmana means sattvic person, a spiritual person, where with a spiritual evolution, he is definitely a very prized entity, and to destroy or kill that would be a tremendous sin. तत्सु ब्रह्मवधेन तत्सदुषैश्च पापैः.
सो दोस पीपल हु क्रूसिफाइड जीसस क्राइस्ट, व्हाट एन अमाउंट ऑफ पाप. और समबडी हु असैसिनेटेड महात्मा गांधी, सो देयर इज नो कैलकुलेशन ऑफ व्हाट पापा दैट इन्वॉल्व्स.
अश्वमेधेन तत्तुल्य पुण्यैश्च.
सपोज इन सम अदर कल्चर देयर इज अ पुण्य कर्म which is not Ashwamedha, but then no Punya Karma can have a result which is greater than Ashwamedha.
So Ashwamedhena tat tulya punyaisya,
or punya which is equivalent to that,
samsaraha kriyate.
We say that there is still within the realm of samsara. And so discussing them is, it includes discussion of everything else.
Yatha ahuhu, this is what this smritikara is saying. स्वसूकर खरोष्ट्राणाम गोजावीमृग पक्षिणाम चंडाल पुलकसानाम च ब्रह्महा योनि मृच्छति ब्रह्महा.
सो इफ यू किल अ ब्राह्मण देन व्हाट काइंड ऑफ योनि यू गेट. इन ब्राह्मण ऑल्सो देर आर एक्सटेंट, यू नो, ब्राह्मण ऑल्सो मे हैव ग्रोन इन सत्वा. सो डिपेंडिंग व्हाट काइंड ऑफ ब्राह्मण यू किल, सो
श्व मीन्स अ डॉग, सूकर मीन्स ए pig, khara means a donkey or ass, ustra a camel, ustranam, go, aja, avi, mruga, pakshi. So go means a cow or a bull, aja means of course a goat, avi means a sheep, mruga means an animal or a deer, pakshi means a bird. So you get this kind of unis.
As you say, go is the highest of the animals, you know. Second is aja. Then avi. Aja means a goat. Then sheep. Then a deer. Then birds. So this is how. And chandala pulkasanam cha. Chandal and pulkasa are the untouchables, you know. So these are the kind of yonis that one gets depending upon the kind of papa that he has incurred.
Brahma yoni mruchadi. So this is the kind of yoni that a brahmaha, one who is skilled brahmana, attains that kind of yoni. Iti. And so, shva, I think dog is the worst, looks like, you know. So little better than dog is a pig. Little better than that is an ass. Little better than is camel. That's how it must be, you know. Anyway, so this is how one qualifies for whatever you mean.
So, when you see this, don't look at them as Brahma, you know, as far as okay, then Brahma Hatya or something, but this is the idea here.
Dharma Rajva Vrajedurdham.
Dharma Rajva, by the Raju of Dharma, by the robe of Dharma, one climbs up.
Papa Rajva Vrajedadha,
by the Raju of the Papa, one climbs down. Iti
cha. धर्म कारणाम अपि,
सो जस्ट स्मृति अपि मीन्स श्रुति ऑल्सो. सो धर्म कारणाम अपि मीनिंग दिस स्मृतिकार ऑल्सो हैज सेड, दैट मीन्स श्रुति हैज सेड ऑफ कोर्स,
तद्यैह रमणीय चरणाः इत्यादि श्रुतीनाम अपि इत्यर्थः.
श्रुति ऑल्सो से तद्यैह रमणीय चरणाः अभ्यासः
हयत्ते रमणीयाम योनिम आपद्येरन्. ब्राह्मण योनिम वा क्षत्रिय योनिम वा वैश्य योनिम वा अथय है.
सो रमणीय शरणाम इन दोज हु आर एक्चुअली परफॉर्मिंग मेरिटोरियस डीड्स, दे बिकम ब्राह्मण क्षत्रिय वैश्य एटसेट्रा. सो दैट इज द पीपल हु परफॉर्म वर्चुअस डीड्स.
बट दोज ये है कपूर चरणाः,
दोज फेलोज हु आर परफॉर्मिंग यू नो ऑफ विशेस ऑफ बैड एक्शंस,
कपूयाम योनि आपद्येरन,
दैट इन दोज लोअर योनिस,
श्व योनिम वा सूकर योनिम वा चंडाल
योनिम वा, बिकम डॉग और अ पिग और चंडाल.
सो दीज एनिमल्स मस्ट बी देयर दोज डेज ऑल्सो, आई गेस, यू नो, विच वी सी हियर. सो दैट काइंड ऑफ थिंग मस्ट बी देयर एट दैट टाइम ऑल्सो, यू नो,
बिकॉज डॉग अकर्स अगेन एंड अगेन, यू नो. एंड सो विद्या विनय संपन्ने ब्राह्मणे गविहस्तिनी सुनी चैव स्वपाके सुनी. So, and there are also the cases when once a female dog came and contaminated some portions of the, you know, the dravya of the yajna and things like that, and how the dog was driven away, and then, so anger, etc. So these incidents are there. So these dogs and pigs, etc., must have been there all those days too. So this is, the idea is that this Brahmana tells us, then this third Brahmana tells us what is the extent of the papa or the prarabdha karma at the samashti level, so what one can attain, and that is still within the realm of samsara. Okay. So now I think we can go to the page 738. Sri Anandagiri, Vidya Sahitam Abhisar Karma Samsara Phalam Vidya Eva Mokshathayadi Swapaksha Shuddhyatham. This footnote people have said Vidya means Brahma Vidya, and that somehow, so Vidya Sahitam Abhikarma Samsara Phalam, the footnote number 7 says Pratyek Yathatma Jnanamatra Vidya. Usually, the karma along with upasana is presented as the means of moksha, you know. But somehow here the word vidya is interpreted by them. It need not be interpreted. The vidya can be interpreted as upasana, then also this is okay. But they have chosen to interpret the word vidya as Brahma vidya. So vidya sahita bhi karma. When Brahma vidya is there, then so karma, when it is combined with Brahma Vidya, then becomes moksha sadhanam. So that is the idea. Or of course, the general argument is when karma is combined with upasana, then karma produces a result that is different from what it can normally produce. Sometimes when you combine two things, then the result is something superior to what each one can produce. That is well known. So when two are combined, then what each can individually accomplish, the in combination the two can accomplish something much greater. So argument here is that you said that the result of karma is within the realm of samsara, but why not karma in combination with some upasanas can give rise to a result which is moksha? Meaning karma can normally give rise to a result that is perishable, but when combined with upasana, why not it can give rise to imperishable? This idea that upasana can change the nature of karma. That the illustration will be given, you know. So vidya sahitamapi karma samsara phalam vidya eva mokshartha. This vidya eva mokshartha, therefore this vidya is. So what vidya is used, vidya eva mokshartha. Vidya itself is only the means of moksha. Since the word vidya is used, and vidya sahitamapi karma, that word vidya is used there. Therefore the word vidya in the same sentence should have the same meaning from that standpoint. The word vidya appears to be interpreted as Brahma vidya. Vidya eva mokshatha iti. Because we never have a paksha that Brahma vidya along with karma gives rise to moksha. Or they only say that person who has Brahma vidya also should continue to perform karma. Otherwise he will get deviated or he will fall down, because non-performance of karma will incur sin and things like that. So that is the usual argument, but argument has not been that the karma should be combined with Brahma Vidya to gain moksha. They say Brahma Vidya is not enough, and that karma is required for Brahma Vidya also to remain mukta. Anyway, Vidya eva moksha thayadi swapaksha shuddhyartham, one's own paksha. Shuddhyartham meaning to clarify one's own paksha, or to release our own paksha from any kind of any kind of a question or a thought defect, you know, any kind of a defect. So this discussion is carried out. Vicharayanna purupakshayati. So Vashyakara, in order to deliberate upon this, that Brahma Vidya alone is a means of moksha, and that karma does not have a scope with reference to moksha, in order to make that point again, purupakshayati. Vashyakara presents the purupaksha in order to perform this vichara or deliberation. Yatvedi. So says Bhashya,
यत्तु कैश्चित् उच्यते विद्या सहितं कर्म निरभिसंधि मंत्र शर्करादि युक्त विशदध्यादिवत कार्यांतरमारभते इति यत्तु कैश्चित् उच्यते। सो यत्तु सी फुटनोट नंबर 3 उक्तरीत्या ब्राह्मणारंभे स्थिते सति उक्तरीत्या सो भाष्यकर हैज सेड व्हाट इज इट दैट दिस ब्राह्मणा डज एज टू हाउ दिस ब्राह्मणा टेल्स अस दैट इवन द मोस्ट एग्जॉल्टेड पुण्य कर्म रिजल्ट ऑफ पुण्य कर्म ऑल्सो इज विद इन रियल ऑफ संसारा एंड देयरफॉर दैट इज द सब्जेक्ट मैटर ऑफ दिस ब्राह्मणा एंड सो वी शुड गो अहेड विद दिस ब्राह्मणा। यदि ब्राह्मणारंभे स्थिते सति कैश्चित् अनिर्ज्ञात आत्मयाथात्मेहि। सो दोस पीपल हु डू नॉट नो द आत्मयाथात्म अनिर्ज्ञात आत्मयाथात्मेहि। सो दोस बाय हुम द आत्मयाथात्म द रियल ग्लोरी ऑफ द आत्मा द रियल डायमेंशन ऑफ द आत्मा द रियल नेचर ऑफ द आत्मा इज नॉट बीन अंडरस्टूड। They don't know what Atma is, or they don't understand. Even the Shruti says, they just don't get the idea, naturally. Because whatever the Shruti says, or whenever we hear the Shruti or any Upadesha, we are going to interpret those words based on what we know. So we will multiply. Ananda that we know will be multiplied in some ways. Even if the mind wants to imagine, or mind wants to understand the idea of all pervasiveness, what will the mind do is try to imagine something that pervades, you know. So, that is how, just as in Taittiriya Upanishad, as well as in this Upanishad also, the Ananda Mimamsa, the arithmetic of Ananda is stated, and you multiply Ananda of different people at 100, you know, different upadhis, 100-fold. So imagine that. So just to give us an idea of the Brahmananda, which is not, which cannot be within the realm of idea, but still the human mind wants to get some idea. And therefore, they also try to imagine Atma to be so and so. And they say, well, this can be done. You know, so whatever imagination, what Atma they have, they feel that is still within the realm of karma and upasana. So it is said, anirjñāda atma-yathātmehi. Those who have not recognized the yathātmyam, the truthful, the true nature of Atma, so they feel that Atma is still something that is attainable. Uchade sudhe se this. What is it? Vidya sahitam karma. So vidya means tattva jnana sahitam. So he repeats that. Vidya sahitam karma. So karma which is combined with brahma vidya. Or karma combined with upasana. Nirabhisandhi means nishkama. Abhisandhi. Phalabhisandhi. Rahitam. So that is devoid of any consideration for karma phala. So karma that is performed without any consideration or motivation for karma phala. Abhisandhi means motivation. So what is that motivates a person to perform karma is karma phala usually. But when the karma is performed without the motivation of karma phala, and when karma such as that is combined with appropriate upasana, then karyantaram arvate, then that karma gains the capability of producing a result which is different from what it can normally produce. In short, karma can normally produce only a result that is perishable and whatever. But he says that when karma is performed without the motivation for karma phala, which is different from ordinary karma, and again when that is performed in combination with upasana, then karma gains the capability of producing a result that is different from what it can normally produce therefrom. He says that you are always making the argument that karma produces perishable result, etc. That is fine. But the karma gains ability to produce something unusual, which is not within the realm of tarka. Tarka is that whatever the limited means will produce a limited end. But even the limited also can produce limitless, when it is combined with something which is suitable. Give us example. Mantra sharkaradi yukta. Vishadadhyadivat Vishendadhi. So says Anandagiri, Yatha kevalam Vishadadhyadi Maranajvaradikaram api. So Visham, if you take poison alone, poison by itself,
it will cause death. If you take this curd by itself, it will cause fever. This is the general understanding in the Ayurveda. Anyway, so, dadhyadi, jvaradikaram api, even tathabi, mantra sharkaradi yuktam, but that visham, when it's taken with mantra, then the mantra changes the nature of visha. And jivanam pushtyadi arabhyade, that visham which normally will take away the life becomes a means of giving you the life when that visha is combined with mantra. So how combination of visha with mantra changes the very nature of visha? Or that dadhi or the curd which normally causes fever, when combined with sharkara, then it gives rise to pushti, you know. Then it gives rise to the pushti. So that is why sarkaradi pushtyadi arabhyate. Otherwise, curd will cause cough. Sharkara also will cause cough. That coughness will remain, I think. But the feverness may go, you know, whatever. Then you get the energy out of that. So, whatever energy, so when curd is combined with sharkara or sugar, then it will be a source of energy. Pushtyadi arabhate. Tatha svataha bandhaphalam api karma. And similarly also karma, which is by itself bandhaphalam, only which will result into bandha, the bondage of new birth and death. Phalabhilasham antarena anusthitam. Nirabhisandhi means phalabhilasham antarena anusthitam. When it is performed without the vilasha or without the motivation of karma phala, that shows how much one is to enjoy the karma. That's all it is. You cannot perform a karma without the phalabhilasha unless you enjoy karma. Unless one enjoys karma. So, when you are enjoying karma, then you alone, your mind is free from what this karma will give rise. When you do not enjoy karma, then mind always looks for what kind of result will come later. Then I want to finish it. When I do not enjoy something, then I want to finish it off, so that I can look forward to something more enjoyable. So, karma is usually not enjoyable, it's usually a burden, therefore one wants to finish it off, so that one is then, one gains the karma phala, which is enjoyable. So, one looks forward to karma phala that is enjoyable, because karma itself is not enjoyable. So, to be able to perform karma without the motivation of karma phala, the karma itself must become enjoyable. I can't perform karma without enjoyment and hope that it is without the motivation of karma phala. Even if I do not want to have any karma phala from this karma, I want to finish up this karma anyway, because I am not enjoying it. So don't think that nishkama karma is a simple thing again. I mean, that I will not have kamana, but he will have kamana. That as long as a fellow is unhappy, there will be kamana, whether you explicitly say that or not. An unhappy person will have the desire to become free from unhappiness. No doubt about that. So any action performed out of unhappiness will be motivated, at least if not for a particular happiness, at least for becoming free from unhappiness. Anyway, so karma must itself become enjoyable. That's why they say, abhyasena to kaunteya. Swamiji says, you know, that if you want to concentrate your mind on something, make it interesting. And that interest can be created by abhyasa. Do it again and again, then you may discover the rasa which is there in the karma itself. So karma must give you rasa swada. Otherwise phala, you always wait for the phala, rasa of the phala. Phala always is rasa. So people wait for that. But if karma itself is rasa, then the rasa of the phala is not important. That's the reason why. So karma itself should become enjoyable. Anyway, so phala vis abhilashamantarena anusthitam. So the argument is that when karma is performed without the abhilasha of phala. Here, of course, all the time our scriptures emphasize the idea of kartavya. That is how they say that when karma is performed with the idea of kartavya, that I must do this, then also it is enough to keep the mind free from the hankering of the karma phala. So sense of obligation, that's also another excellent thing that has been, excellent idea that is given to us, sense of obligation. I feel obliged to do something. That means when I feel obliged to do something, that means that I am actually paying back the debt which I already have incurred. So when I return the debt, then there is no expectation of any gain from there anyway. Otherwise, whenever I give something to anybody, there is always an expectation of some return, that return of favor. So when I give 1,000 rupees to somebody, there is some expectation of return of favor. But when I return the 1,000 rupees which I had borrowed, then there is no expectation of favor. So when I understand that, I am already obliged, which is a very beautiful thing, you know. So they say that everybody, these are all obligatory duties. That already I am obliged, already I am receiving the favor, and therefore it is my duty. It is becoming of me, it behooves of me to do a given thing in response to the obligation that I already have. So when I perform an action with that idea of obligation, then also my mind will not expect anything, which is fine also. But we hope that we enjoy that obligatory duty. Otherwise, obligatory duty itself is a burden. People don't expect anything. At the same time, they don't enjoy anything. They don't want to do it, and you have to do. So, kartavya. Kartavya is that which is to be done, or hopefully that which I want to do, you know, kartavya. Dātavyam idiyat dānam. So, this dānam or the gift must be given. That is the kind of idea or the motivation that comes from me. Hey, I should give this. Then it becomes an act of pleasure. I should do this. Then it becomes, that happens also. I have a sense of gratitude whenever I realize that I have been favored. Then a sense of gratitude arises in me. And whenever I do something out of gratitude, then there is no resistance at all. It is a sense of gratitude that actually motivates me and pushes me. Pushes me means gives the impetus to do something. Therefore, the sense of gratitude. So either it is a hobby, either it's a work that I enjoy, or it is a work that is motivated by a sense of gratitude, that it can be nishkama karma, otherwise it is very difficult for karma to be nishkama.
Anyway, phala vilasham antarena anusthitam vidya samuchitam mokshaya kshamam. The argument is that karma, which is performed without the motivation for karma phala, and combined with upasana, so two things change the nature of karma. So that's what Bhashyakara says, yogaha karmasu kausharam. Tasmad yoga ayujyasva yogaha karmasu kausharam. Bhashyakara explains that yoga means Ishwararma buddhi. That's a real kushalta in performing karma, because it changes the very nature of karma. It's bandhanatmakam. That karma which normally binds, that karma is transformed into that which actually becomes means of liberation. That is real kushalata. So Ishwararma buddhi is kushalata. Yoga is kushalata. Or yoga is really skill of transforming the nature of karma. That's the argument made here, which we accept also. Except that even that karma is not an immediate direct means of moksha. It is an indirect means of moksha that is accepted. But they want to say that some kind of a apurva, some unusual result comes. These Vedantins, many of also believe that when you repeat aham brahmasmi, then that repetition called parisankhyanam has the ability to produce some apurva, some unusual result. And thus moksha or the realization comes. So, this is the question here. Then Anandagiri continues, muktehe sadhyatvangikare samuchita karma sadhyatvam syat mokshasya sadhyatva angikare. Only when moksha is accepted with sadhya, something to be attained, so it is apraptasya praptahi. If moksha is looked upon as that which is apraptam, not attained, and has to be attained, then what you say is right. But here we are talking about pranitya praptasya praptahi. Attainment of that which is already attained. Samuchita karma sadhyatvam syat. If it is sadhyam, then of course samuchita karma, meaning karma combined with upasana, can be a means of attainment of that moksha. Natu tasyaha sadhyatvam. Tasya muktehe. Natu muktehe sadhyatvam. But mukti is not sadhya according to us. Dhimatrayat tattvat.
Dhimatra ayat-tattvat. It only depends upon dhiyo, the knowledge. Meaning Atma or Brahma or even God also is not someone to be attained, he is someone to be known. And that which separates me from God is the ignorance of God and not the absence of God. It is not that God is absent or not here, that I am not able to experience Him or I am not able to see Him, but it is that I do not know that He is here, and that is that lack of knowledge is what creates the distance between myself and God, and not the separation, the real separation from God. This is a wonderful thing, you know. Right? And the moksha means God, that God is not away, it is right here and now. This is the main thing that Vedanta has to say. And here and now, and that I am that, because I am alone here and now. And what is that I is something to be understood. Dhimatra ayat-tattva, it is merely dependent upon dhi, meaning the Brahma Vidya, or it is jnana-vritti. Dhi means jnana-matra adhinatva. Moksha is only dependent upon jnanam. Therefore, uttaramaha tannaiti. Samashyakara says, tanna anarabhyatvata mokshasya. Says, no. Even if karma's nature is changed, then also that changed karma whose nature is changed also cannot give rise to moksha. You may be right, we don't object to that, but that when karma is combined with upasana, that it can give rise to a phala which is different from what it can normally give rise, we accept that, possible. But still it cannot give rise to moksha. Because karma's nature, even if it changes, can give rise to something that is unattained, that is for sure. So karma can attain something that is unattained, but an effort can produce something that is not produced, or effort can enable me to reach somewhere where I am not, but no effort can actually give rise to something which is already there or which is already attained. This is logical. Anarabhyatvat mokshasya akaryatvat. Moksha is not a karya, moksha is not a product. Hetumeva sadhayati anarabhyatvat, that is a hetu. So, because moksha is akarya, therefore. So, how is moksha akarya? That is sadhayati, that is what Bhashyakara establishes or arrives at here, bandhanayati. Bandhananasha evahi moksha nakarya bhutaha. Says, bandhananasha evahi moksha. Moksha is not something new. It is bandhana-nashaha. Merely destroying the bondage is called moksha and not attaining something. Na karya-bhutaha. It is not that moksha is produced, it is that an obstacle is removed. Even antahakaran-shuddhi also is not a product. It is that, and it's not that antahakaran-shuddhi is produced, it is that ashuddhi is removed. This is how everything is praptasya praptahi. Kim tad bandhanam? You say that bandhananasa eva moksha, that the destruction of bondage is moksha. Kim tad bandhanam? What is that bondage? Then Bhashyakara says bandhanam chaiti. Bandhanam cha avidya ityavo chama. We already said bandhanam cha avidya. Bondage is ignorance. Davochama. You said that. Then says Anandagiri, avidyanashopi karmarabhyo bhavishyatiti. All right. So even if ignorance is supposed to be the bondage, we say that karma can eliminate ignorance also. Why not? Avidyanashopi karmarabhya. Karma means karma karya. That even ignorance also can be destroyed by karma. Why not? Iti chet na. If this is what you say, the answer is no. How? Avidyayascha. Avidyayascha na karmana nashaha upapadyade. Avidyayascha nashaha karmana na upadyade. And karma, which is a product of ignorance, cannot destroy ignorance itself. And so, what is it?
Avirodhitaya karma na avidyam vinivartate. Avirodhitaya karma na avidyam vinivartate. Karma is not virodhi. And so, vidya vidyam nihanteva. Avidya can be only destroyed by that which is virodhi of avidya, which is vidya or ignorance. Like darkness cannot be removed by any amount of activity, it can only be removed by the light. And so also ignorance cannot be removed by any activity, it can only be removed by knowledge. Avidyayascha na karma nasha upadyate. So says Anandagiri, mokshaha na karma sadhya. Avidya astamayatvat. Rajya vidya astamayat ityartha. So this is that anumana was anarabhyatvat, you know. So hetu was given. So what is the nature of the anumanam is stated here by Anandagiri. Mokshaha na karma sadhya. Tanna. Na means what? Mokshaha na karma sadhya. Moksha is not the result of karma. Why? Anarabhyatvat. So avidya astamayatvat. Moksha is not anarabhya. Why? Because bandhananasha eva moksha. And so avidya astamayatvat. All that moksha calls for is astamaya, the cessation of ignorance. Rajva vidya astamayatvat ityartha. Like the Rajva Vidya, the ignorance of the rope is what brings about the cessation of the fear from the snake, etc. And so also it is cessation of ignorance which is moksha. And not that something new is produced. Avidya only conceals what is there. Just as darkness conceals what is there and keeps it away from our perception. Similarly also ignorance conceals what is there, namely the fullness of the Atma. So in this case, ignorance conceals the fullness of Atma. Does not conceal the Atma totally. It conceals the fullness, the Vishesha. So the non-duality, the limitlessness of the Atma is what is concealed by Avidya. And so when the Avidya is destroyed, that limitlessness becomes evident and that is moksha. Ityatha. Okay. I will continue tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Vadarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadhyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om Kesi Duchyate Vidya Sahitam Karma Nirvisandhi Manta Sarkaradi Yukta Vishad Adhyadivat Karyantanam arvade dichet. So some people say who do not know the Atma Yathatmya. So anirgnyata Atma Yathatmya hi. Those people who do not know the true nature of the self, they say that this karma can be combined with Brahma Vidya. And then the karma attains a different kind of a nature, characteristic by which normally the karma which creates bondage will bring about liberation. Meaning that when karma is combined with vidya, means either Brahma Vidya or Upasana, then somehow there takes place a transformation in the nature of karma. The idea is that when you combine one thing into something else, is it possible that its nature can get transformed? So yes,
like Vishama, this poison which normally kills, so when that is combined with mantra, then the very poison becomes the cause of swastham, health. And curd, which normally causes fever, when combined with sugar, then becomes the cause of nourishment. So how these things, when combined with something else, their nature gets transformed. And similarly also karma, by itself, it creates bondage. But when combined with vidya, then its nature changes and it becomes a means of liberation. Why not that way? This would have been all right. Tanna anarabhyatvat mokshasya. Mukte sadhyatvangikare samuchyada karma sadhyatvam syat. Mukte sadhyatva angikare. If you accepted mukti or moksha, something that can be attained. Meaning moksha is not an obtaining fact. What is meant by attainment is that it doesn't obtain right now, and that by doing something that it becomes, you know, it is obtained. Either it is created or reached or whatever. And so, sadhyam. Sadhyam is that which is to be accomplished, which is not presently accomplished. Had moksha been of that nature, which is presently not accomplished, meaning what? Bondage is presently there. And the real bondage had to be removed. So moksha had been this, that the bondage was real. And a real moksha had to be brought into effect, let's say. Then yes, karma would definitely have its application, because when you change something, when you bring about a change, if something is bound and you release that, natural effort is required. Natasyaha sadhyatvam. However, this mukti or liberation is not something that is to be accomplished. Meaning it is not something which is non-existent right now and has to be brought into existence. Anarabhyatvat mokshasya. Bandhanashevahi moksha. So Anandagiri said, dhimatra ayattatvat iti. So meaning that jnanamatra adhinatvat. That moksha purely depends upon knowledge. It is ignorance that brings about this idea of bondage, and knowledge brings about this elimination of that bondage. This is how it is. Bandhanashevahi moksha. It is the elimination of bondage which is called moksha. Na karya bhutaha. So not that moksha is brought about, but it is that some obstacle is removed. Bandhanam cha avidya iti avochama. And we already said that what is called bandhana or bondage is nothing other than avidya or ignorance. Avidyayascha na karmana nashaha upadyate. The question was all right. If ignorance is that which is an obstacle to moksha, then why not we say that the karma can remove ignorance? Then also karma can become a means of moksha. Avidyayascha na karmana nashaha upadyate. But avidyayaha nashaha, ignorance cannot be removed by karma. Drishta vishayatvacha karma samarthasya. Okay, now so we are on the page 739, second line, drishta vishayatvacha karma samarthasya. So that's what tatra hetvantramaha Anandagiri says. So there itself another hetu, that moksha is karma sadhya. There another hetu is being stated, drishta vishayatva. So let us read that here. Drishta vishayatvacha karma samarthasya. So what is meant by drishta vishayatva? Karma samarthyam. Karmanaha samarthyam. The capability of karma is something that is well known. See, footnote number 1 explains this expression, drishta vishayatvacha. So footnote number 1 says, karyam yadva tad vishayaha drishtaha eva pariganitaha iti yavata. So kari vishayatvacha karma samarthasya. Drishta means, can mean karyam. meaning that karma can bring about, karma can bring about an effect, it can bring about an effect. Oh, drishti vishyatvad, drishtaha tad vishyaha eva, so pariganitaha ityavada. Or whatever karma can do is something that is already counted, meaning it is something that is already known to us. So whatever karma can do, samarthya or capability of karma is something that is well known to us. And so Anandagiri says, na karma sadhya mukti iti sheshaha. And so mukti is not karma sadhya. See footnote number 6, mukti hi na karma sadhya akaryatvat ishvaradivat iti vivakshitam. So mukti hi na karma sadhya akaryatvat. Since moksha is not a product, therefore it cannot be accomplished by an effort. Karma means any effort. It is not that one can get liberated by an effort. Because the moment a person makes an effort to get liberated, already there is a conclusion that I am bound. So only when bondage is given reality that there can be an effort to become liberated. Since don't give reality to bondage at all, and that's all. So seeing the bondage to be unreal itself is a way of becoming free from bondage. And that is the knowledge. So knowledge about the true nature of bondage is that bondage is unreal, that's all. Of course something is unreal is known only when something real is known, and therefore that moksha is real or atma is real and bondage is unreal, that understanding alone brings about an elimination of or cessation of bondage. So mukti hi na karma sadhya akaryatvat ishvaradivata. Anything that karyam, anything akaryam, uncreated, nasti kritah krutena, as Mundaka Upanishad says, akrutena kritah nasti. Krutena, nasti kritah krutena, akritah krutena nasti. Krutena means karmana. So by karma you cannot attain something that akrita or uncreated. That is uncreated has to be here and now and everywhere. Uncreated means that which is there and has to be there at all the times. Otherwise you can't say it is uncreated. And if something is there all the times, it must be there in all the places also. Something cannot be there all the time and not in all the places and not in all those conditions. It must be there at all the times means in all the places, in all the conditions, everywhere. Ishvara is like that. Atma is like that. So they are uncreated. Therefore they must be such as must be there right now and so not to be accomplished, to be known. So Swami says, Ishvara, you don't have to believe in God, you have to understand God. So God is not to be believed in, God is to be understood. And therefore, Anandagiri said, na karma sadhya mukti iti sheshaha. Therefore, mukti is not something that is to be accomplished by karma. Tadeva spashtayadi. Karma samarthasya dushta vishatvam. That karma has a capability which is well known to us. That itself, Bhashyakara clarifies, utpatti. Utpatti, apti, vikara samskarahi, karma samarthasya vishayaha. Utpadayitum, prapayitum, vikartum, samskartum cha samarthyam karmanah na atah vyatirikta vishayah asti karma samarthasya loke aprasiddhatvad. Utpatti apti vikara samskarahahi karma samarthasya vishadrashtaha. These are all known to us. Utpatti, so to create something, produce something which was not there. Apti, to attain somewhere, attain something where we are not. Attainment of something which is separated from me in space, let us say, or in time. Attainment of something that is separated from me in space and time would be called apti. Utpatti, something that does not exist right now and to bring into existence would be called utpatti, like the crops, etc., grains, etc. Apti meaning reaching another place or reaching another time, etc. Then vikara, bring about a modification. a thing is in one state and to modify it into another state. And so something is cold, make it hot and so forth, so that kind of vikara or change about a transformation like milk transform into curd, so all of this is vikara. And samskara, purification of a given thing. So what is impure, remove the impurities, purification. So this is something that karma can do. This is how they have thought about it, what you can accomplish by effort. These four kinds of things can be accomplished by effort. I have not given more thought to that, but perhaps there is no fifth. They must have given a great deal of thought, you know, that you can create something, you can reach somewhere, you can transform or change something, or you can purify something. This is all you can do with an effort. Karma samarthasya vishayaha. So this is what karma samarthasya vidya. These are the objects of the capability of karma, meaning this is where karma has its application. Uktameva karma samarthya vishayam anvyavyatekabhyam sadhayati. That is utpatti, apti, etc. is the vishaya or the subject matter or the scope of karma. So this is where the karma or action is the scope. And that itself is anvyavyatekabhyam sadhayati bhashyakara. Again establishes that by anvaya and vyatireka. So where karma is there, these things are there, or vice versa, and so anvaya vyatireka. So said, utpadayitam, prapayitam, vikartam, samskartam cha samarthyam karmana. That karma can do this. It can create, it can enable you to reach, it can change, and it can purify. So samskartam cha samarthyam karmana. Na atah vidirikta vishaya asti karma samarthasya. Other than that, the karma has no scope. So karma has a scope to accomplish this much, and there is no fifth one. That needs a lot of confidence to say, but anyway, and so karma cannot do anything more than this. Loke aprasiddhatva. So aprasiddhatva di chedaha. So those days, of course, they didn't have an avagraha chinha. Nowadays, in 20, we have avagraha chinha to indicate that when akara is elided. But this was not the practice earlier. This practice must have come later on. And particularly when all this was passed on by word of mouth, of course, avagraha chinha you can't hear. And therefore, sometimes you do not know whether an akara is there or not, and so an explanation becomes necessary. And still also we find some old kind of printing where they do not write avagraha chinha. Then you have to see an akara there. They just write everything together. Loke prasiddhatva, that's what they will say. Within one word, of course. So then we have to sometimes, whether the words are joined because they are not printed properly or that there is a sandhi involved there, etc., then you have to see from the context. But anyway, aprasiddhatva di chedaha. So idea is that prasiddhi is that karma can do this and that karma cannot do anything more than that. This is something, loke prasiddhatva, this is also well known, or people do not know of any other samarthya of karma than this fourfold samarthya. Utpatyadinam anyatamatvat mokshasyavi karma samarthya visheta syadichet na ityaha nacha. Utpatyad, all right. We say that the karma can bring about, so utpatyadinam anyatamatvat. All right, karma can bring about utpatti, apti, vikara and samskara. Okay. But we say that the moksha falls in any one of these four. Karma may not have capability beyond these four, but if moksha happens to be falling in the category of one of these four, utpatyadinam anyatamatvat, meaning one of them. Moksha being one of the utpatti, etc. Mokshasyabhi karma samarthya visheda syad. Suppose moksha happens to be either apta or utpadya or apta or vikari or samskarya, then karma can accomplish moksha. Idhi chetna, Subhashyakara says no. Nacha moksha Esham padarthanam anyatamaha. And moksha is not one of these four. Meaning is not utpadya Apya, Vikarya or Samskarya. Therefore, moksha cannot be the subject matter of, or karma cannot have scope with reference to moksha. So Anandagiri says, why? How come moksha does not fall in the category, any one of these categories? Nityatvat, Atmatvat, Kutasthatvat, Nityashuddhatvat, Nirgunatvat, Chaityartha. So Nityatvat, no Utpadyatva, moksha is Nitya. Let us Atma. Atma is Nitya. Therefore moksha also is Nitya. Nitya means that which obtains it all the time. And therefore, Nityatvat, no Utpadyatvam. The question of creating something comes only when it is not there at a given time. Since moksha is that which is ever there, therefore it cannot be fall in the category of Utpadyam. It cannot be something that is to be created because it is always there. Atmatvat na apyatvam. Moksha is my own self. That being the case, it is not something to be reached. So, I have to reach something that is separated from me in terms of space and time. But then, time of course, it is nitya. Space, had it been elsewhere, then I would have to reach that atmatvat. Moksha being my own self, it cannot be something to be reached either. Kutasthatvat na vikarya. Kutastha means changeless. Atma being kutastha, changeless, you cannot bring about any change. And therefore, moksha cannot be accomplished as a result of a change. Nitya shuddhatvata samskariha is ever pure, Atma is ever pure, and therefore no need for purification. Is ever there, no need of creating. Is my own self, no need of accomplishing, reaching. Is ever pure, and therefore, and changeless, therefore, no question of changing it. Nirgunatvacha, and then nirgunatvat. So, Nirgunatvat means also that it cannot be, it doesn't have any qualities, etc. Therefore, it vikaryam, samskaryam, etc. cannot be there. Atmatvat. Then Anandagiri says, Atma bhuto yathokta moksha. If according to you moksha is the very self, tarhi kimidi sarvesham na prasadayati ashinkyaha. Then how come everybody doesn't know about it? If moksha is the very nature of the self, then how come it is not something that is known to everybody, that I am mukta, that I am liberated? How come everybody does not know about it? So Bhashyakara is avidyayati. Avidya matra vyavahitah.